Hey guys, Dan the RBRT guy here. Hey look, before I start the video this week, I just want to call your attention that the SAE and Metric Deep 3/8 socket extractors are in Flyer 12 this month. Get a hold of your Mac guy or call 1-800-MAC-TOOLS for the deal. Hope you'll enjoy the video. Thanks very much. Hey guys, Dan the RBRT guy back with you again. Hey, thanks so much for coming back this week and checking out the new video. So this week, guys, we got kind of a cool project. A buddy of mine bought a used mower, and when he flipped over this deck to change the blades, this is what he found. Now, as I spin this blade around, I want you to see just how rusted and rounded out that is. In fact, it's chewed up so bad that I've got a regular socket here to show that I can just spin it around with my hands. The other side, however, whoever tried to do this did not try to take this other side off. It looks like it's in pretty good shape. So when my buddy said, hey Dan, have you got anything that'll take this off? Immediately I thought socket extractor. It's an awesome opportunity for me to show you guys just how versatile this socket extractor line is. We're gonna go ahead and remove this rounded rusty nut, but then we're also gonna come over here and preemptively use it on this good nut, because you know what? If this one was that tight, this one's probably stuck and frozen on there too. So instead of trying and maybe rounding it out, we're gonna use our socket extractor to take that off of there. And I'm gonna show you guys just how versatile this socket extractor line can be. Come on, let's get at it. Okay guys, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna set this up. I've got my socket extractor here, and we're gonna go ahead and take a hammer and beat this bad boy on there. Now when these things lock in, they lock in tight. So let's get it on there. That looks like it bit in there pretty well. And I've got myself a breaker bar. Let's see if we can crack this thing loose. Well, I'll try to position it about right there. Oh boy, she's tight. Yep, she's real tight. Okay. Well, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I wasn't expecting it to be that tight. But it's obvious that that bad boy is on there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reset the scene a little bit. I'm gonna take a socket extractor and I'm gonna pound it onto the bottom nut of the pulley that I'm holding onto this with so that it doesn't rotate. And then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna put it into the bench vise so that it's really stable, and I'll go ahead and I'll jack up the other side and get it stable so the whole platform's nice and stable, because sitting on that wood obviously wasn't gonna get it. I reviewed the footage on that. You could see the breaker bar flexing. I mean, I had some beef on that. So I'm gonna reset the scene, and then I'm gonna show you something really cool about our socket extractor design that nobody else has. Only RBRT has it. I'll be right back with you. Let me reset. We'll get after it. All right guys, we're back, and I've got it set up a little bit different. So what I've done is I've taken another socket extractor and pounded it on the pulley on the bottom, put it in the bench vise, and locked it down tight. Now I know that socket extractor is not gonna slip off of there. I'm pretty sure we're gonna be stable that way. As you can see, I've braced it up on a wheel with a block. All I'm doing is supporting that edge. And there's the little beauty right there. Now, one of the cool things that nobody else has, only RBRT, is the F.O.R. forcing rod. And this is where the versatility to these tools really comes into play. This little rod threads in through the bottom like this. Now, it has a couple of different purposes, okay? The main purpose, obviously, is when you extract the metal that you're trying to extract, that rod will force it out the tip so you're not taking it over the vise and trying to beat it out of there and causing any damage. It just pushes it nice and clean right out of the tool. Saves any headache. It's a nice feature. But one of the other really cool functions of that is when you get into a situation like this and whatever you're trying to get out obviously isn't coming out easily, that little rod now becomes a puller. And it allows me to pull the socket up off of the fastener. Just like that. Now you can see the grooves that my tool made and the indentations it made when it was beaten down on there. It was locked in really tight. But one of the cool things about that rod being able to force it off is now I can add a little bit of heat. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna heat this bolt up. And, you know, a little heat sometimes is what you need, right? So let's go ahead and get this good and hot. And I've also went and got myself a bigger breaker bar. I think this one's like on the 26 inch long or 30 inch long. So we're gonna be able to put a little bit more leverage on it, and we'll get it done this time. Or by gosh, we'll snap that right off trying. All right, so that looks like it's pretty hot. We're gonna go ahead and take our socket extractor, pound it back down on there. Now I've got myself a really decent breaker bar. She's locked in good and tight. Actually, let's go this way. Righty tighty, lefty loosely, right guys? As far as I know. Get in there. Let's see if we can get her out. Oh, and there it is, baby. There it is. Look at that. Little bit of heat. The best grip on the planet. Now, the thing is, guys, twist sockets work pretty well. But you can't take a twist socket out with an F.O.R. rod, heat that bolt up. You know, once that twist socket locks in, you don't dare try. Well, how are you going to get it off of there? How are you going to get it off? Once those things bite in, if it ain't coming out, now you got yourself a tiger by the tail. Look at that. So what we're going to do is I'm going to reset. You'll see me splice it in a little bit here. I'm going to reset, and we're going to go ahead and bang the socket extractor down on that good bolt because I'm sure it's tight. We'll heat it up. We're not playing around with this. I'll be right back. Okay, guys, we're back. I've got the whole thing set back up again, and I've grabbed the mini ductor. We're going to go ahead and heat up this bolt, so let's give it a little bit of heat. She's getting good and hot. All right, that's probably hot enough. So we're going to go ahead and grab our socket extractor and bash it on. Now, what I want to do is I want to show you that this bolt's in relatively good shape. It's not been stripped. I don't think it's ever been touched. We're going to use the socket extractor on this because we feel that, you know, we don't want to round it out. The other one rounded out. So the chances of this one rounding out with a conventional socket are pretty good, or a wrench. So we're going to go ahead and bash down our socket extractor. And, you know, you can use these preemptively. It's great because I'm going to go ahead and reinstall that when I'm done. You know, these are impact grade tools. So I would never use an impact gun on something that was rounded like that because you just take all the control out of your hands. You know what I'm saying? But on something like this, I think I'm going to grab the old impact gun and see if I can get this out using the impact gun. So let's see how we do. Oh yeah, no trouble at all. Came right on out of there. Not a problem. Okay guys, we've got the blade back on there. We're gonna go ahead and reinstall this good nut carefully so we don't do any cross-threading. And down we go. And then we're gonna go ahead and grab the FOR rod, put it on there, and we'll be able to pull that up off of this fastener. Can you see the versatility of these tools? They're just fantastic. And one of the main things I want you to see is you can have a look. Even though indeed I did make some marks down the side, I didn't damage the shoulder wells of that. So there's no problem with me using a regular socket the next time I want to take this apart. It didn't damage it. It put a little bit of crease right down the center of the flat. The shoulders are still perfectly intact, so preemptively using a socket extractor on a bolt that you think might give you a problem is not a problem. And then use the FOR rod to pop it off after you've tightened it down. This thing's ready to ship. You know, another neat little feature that I don't know if I've talked about in the past with other videos about these, something that's really cool, just in parting, is the dual drive system. You see, it's got a hexagonal shape on the end, so if I needed to put a 3/4 gun on there, I could put another socket over top of that and use a 3/4 gun if I wanted to, or use some other kind of drive setup if I didn't want to use the anvil drive in the back. All of the socket extractors from 1/4 inch, 3/8 and half have that design, so you can see how handy that would be. And instead of using a hog ring hole, we've used the little nubs, the little notches on each corner for a ratchet so that the detent ball will sit in there so it's no problem. You know, they really are very well thought out. And the versatility with the F.O.R rod just puts us at another level. So guys, do me a favor. If you liked the video, this was kind of a cool one, give the video a like. If you haven't done it yet, subscribe to the channel and please share this information out with your friends, because I really do think that the RBRT line as a whole, but these socket extractors that we've showcased in this video, really do make a job a lot easier when you're dealing with this kind of thing. I'm Dan, the RBRT guy. Make sure you hit that bell so you can see when the next new video comes at you. I'll see you next time, guys. Thanks very much.